entrance antiphon, remember your compassion, O Lord, and your merciful love, for they are from of old. Let not our enemies exalt over us. Redeem us, O God of Israel, from all our distress.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, we gather to celebrate this Lenten Mass. As we begin, we call to mind our sins, seek God's mercy, and the grace to worship well.
Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, look kindly on the devotion of your people, that those who by their works of self-denial are restrained in body may also, by the fruit of their good works, be renewed in mind and heart. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. He lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of prophet Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah a second time. Set out for the great city of Nineveh and announce to it the message that I will tell you. So Jonah made ready and went to Nineveh according to the Lord's bidding. Now Nineveh was an enormous large city. It took 3 days to go through. Jonah began his journey through the city and had gone but a single day's walk announcing, 40 days more and Nineveh shall be destroyed. When the people of Nineveh believed God, they proclaimed a fast, and all of them, great and small, put on sackcloth. When the news reached the king of Nineveh, he rose from his throne, laid aside his robe, covered himself with sackcloth, and sat in the ashes. Then he had this proclaimed throughout Nineveh, by decree of the king and his nobles, neither man nor beast, neither cattle nor sheep, shall taste anything. They shall not eat, nor shall they drink water. Man and beast shall be covered with sackcloth and call loudly to God. Every man shall turn from his evil ways and from the violence he has in hand. Who knows, God may relent and forgive, and without his blazing wrath, so that we shall not perish. When God saw by their actions how they turned from their evil ways, he repented of the evil that he had threatened to do to them. He did not carry it out. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm, a heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
A heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt, and of my sins cleanse me.
A heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me.
A heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humbled. O God, you will not spurn.
A heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you,
Even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, for I am gracious and merciful. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
While still more people gathered in the crowd, Jesus said to them, "This generation is an evil generation. It seeks a sign, but no sign will be given it except the sign of Jonah. Just as Jonah became a sign to the Ninevites, so will the Son of Man be to this generation. At the judgment, the Queen of the South will rise with the men of this generation, and she will condemn them, because she came from the ends of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon, and there is something greater than Solomon here. At the judgment, the men of Nineveh will rise with this generation and condemn it. Because of the preaching of Jonah, they repented, and there is something greater than Jonah here." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The church and the readings hit hard at the beginning of Lent, of course, to entice us to join the march or to join the group of people who are taking on Lent. Lent is actually the sign of Jonah for us. And the preaching and the gospels and the readings we hear are all designed to call us all to repent. Can you imagine just for a moment if in the book of Jonah, the powerful language that Jonah used and how he attracted everybody, you know, the kings and the animals and the people, all to don sackcloth and ashes. He had to be very powerful in his speech and to be very effective in telling them what would happen if they didn't change their lives. And the same thing with Jesus. He attracted many people, and so his language was very powerful, and he was very straightforward. So the idea for us is to be called to a particular sign, and that is on Ash Wednesday, we start our Lenten season, and we're trying to to change our own lives, and we should be calling everybody to do this somehow. How the church is trying, obviously, and we have to each be a part of that call to people in our family and our lives, to the people at work. We call them to think about God and what happens if we don't change our lives. And it's obvious that this world that we're living in to now is another yet evil generation. We need to make sure that the preaching and the teachings of the church are heard very effectively. So like Jonah at Nineveh, we need to call people. And like Jesus said, there is no more person more effective in this generation than he in his preaching. And so that is the task that we have, is somehow to get people to be more attentive. And then when we get their attention, then everybody needs to change, because that's the idea of Lent. We're about changing ourselves, being more attentive to the changes that we need to make from sin to goodness. So Jesus said, though, in the very beginning is that, and Jonah, we heard it very effectively there, the first words were, "The word of the Lord came to Jonah." Okay? And Jesus said, he is a more effective word. And anytime we hear somebody saying, talking about the word, we're talking about listening again. And we go back to the time of Adam and Eve, and they didn't listen to the word of God. So our task for today is, first of all, to be attentive to what we each need in our own lives, listen to the word of God and how we're going to change, and then we need to be more attentive in spreading the word of God so that people will, too, come and want to change their lives.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Trusting in God's faithfulness, we pray with confidence.
We pray for the church. May the Spirit give us courage to spread the good news. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in governance and public office, may the Lord strengthen them in leadership and guide their hearts towards charity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who feel they cannot be forgiven, may the compassion of God open their hearts to the abundant mercy that he has. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are gathered here today, may God grant us the grace that this Lent to recognize our sins and to turn back to him. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for those who have died. May they be welcomed into the kingdom of God by the mercy of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for your intentions that you bring here today, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious and loving God, we are your people, trusting in your promises, that you hear us. In your way and time, always answer us. Through your Son, Christ Jesus, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God. For the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ as he humbled himself to share in our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me of all my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. O Lord, we offer to you what you have given to be dedicated to your name, so that just as for our benefit you make these gifts a sacrament, so may let them become for us an eternal remedy. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for through our bodily fasting, you restrain our faults, raise up our minds, and bestow both virtue and its rewards upon us. Through Christ, the angels and saints worship together in exaltation. May our voices now join with theirs, as in humble praise we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look upon your people's offerings and pour out upon them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too have become your sons and daughters. Indeed, Though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with ever greater love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of a cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. And as he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on a cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate this memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead and look forward to his second coming. We offer you, our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the entire human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself through the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as we partake of this one bread and one chalice, that we may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart with Francis, our Pope, Walker, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom until that hour when we stand before you, saints among saints, in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we now humbly commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wounds of corruption, and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Lord's command, informed by his teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant to her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of Christ be with each one of you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. Amen. The body of Christ.
The communion antiphon. All who take refuge in you shall be glad, O Lord, and ever cry out their joy, and you shall dwell among them.
Sister of the body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ, Pat. The body of Christ, dear. The body of Christ, my friend. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ, star. The body of Christ, my friend.
Amen.
The body of Christ, dear. The body of Christ, great.
Amen.
The body of Christ, dear. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ, Marianne. The body of Christ, my dear. The body of Christ, sister. The body of Christ, sister.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Let us pray. O Lord, watch over us, your people, and in your kindness, cleanse us from all our sins. For if evil has no dominion over us, no trial can do us harm. This we ask through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. We all proclaim the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.